Meanwhile, suspended Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. urges President Marcos to fire his justice secretary. Teves says Jesus Crispin Remulla should be sacked if his recent claims are proven to be false. Remulla claimed last week that Teves joined a group of 13 people who traveled to Timor-Leste on a private jet. Teves denies this. The suspended congressman also calls for a probe into alleged attempts to bribe witnesses to the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel de Gamo, in which Teves is alleged to be the mastermind.
Ngayon ang panahon na i-assess ni BBM ang integridad ng tao niya. Kung hindi masagot ni Boying Remulla ang aking pinaka-importanting dalawang tanong, sa tingin ko dapat sibaki na siya ni BBM. Ibabalik ko ang aking tanong, paano nagkasya ang 13 na tao sa isang 9-seater na aeroplano? Paano nagkasya ang 6 na tao sa isang 5-seater na helicopter? Dahil kung hindi nila masagot yun, then sinungaling yung pronouncement nila na iyon.
Remulla dismissed the lawmaker's dare and urged him to face the accusations against him instead.
I don't have to prove anything here. Siya yung kailangan niya i-prove na kaya niya humarap sa charges. Umuwi na lang siya. Doon siya magpaliwanag sa korte. Tsaka sa DOJ. Huwag sa akin dito.
A word war erupts between the allies of House Speaker Martin Romualdez and Vice President Sara Duterte as a rift between President Marcos's top allies appears to be widening further. RG Cruz with a full story.
Talks of a coup at the House of Representatives had started to simmer down by the time the 19th Congress adjourned sine die last May 31. But the apparent peace was shattered again less than a week later with the latest remark of Vice President Sara Duterte during an event of her office. On Monday, Duterte reaffirmed in her speech at the Pasidungog or tribute to the OVP's partners and supporters in Pasay City her love and friendship with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. But not before a remark that caught the attention of the supporters of the president's cousin, Speaker Martin Romualdez.
Before anything else, I would like to acknowledge the all-out support of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to the office of the Vice President. Hindi ko nabanggitin ang middle initial niya.
2 days later, Cavite Representative Elpidio Barasaga would begin what would eventually be a series of pro-Romualdez press statements by 6 congressmen. But while Representatives El Rey Villafuerte, Johnny Pimentel, and House Majority Leader Manuel Jose de Lipe would skip any direct reference to Duterte and stick to extolling Romualdez's achievements as Speaker while calling for an end to political bickering, Barasaga pointedly claimed in his press release that Romualdez has a role in Duterte's vice presidency. Barasaga's press release, which referred to him as a former president of the National Unity Party, pointed out that Romualdez tremendously helped in pushing for the vice presidential candidacy of Duterte, who was eventually recruited to join Lacas. It also said that Romualdez became close to the vice president because he was among those who convinced her to run for the post under the UNITEAM ticket, which was headed by his cousin, who is now the president. That was after Barasaga pointedly referenced Duterte's remark at her speech last Monday, where she mentioned she will no longer mention the president's middle initial, R, meaning Romualdez, and named the president and the speaker Cher as they are first cousins. But by the end of the day on Wednesday, Duterte would fire back, especially at Barasaga. Duterte came out to say that the speaker had no role in her decision to run for vice president, calling the claim that Romualdez tremendously pushed for her candidacy acutely inaccurate and an insult to her supporters. The VP also revealed that it was Senator Aimee Marcos and eventually the president himself who were in discussions with her to be the president's running mate. Netizens, meantime, dug up Duterte's speech back in June 2022, where she thanked Romualdez for his efforts as her campaign manager.
I'd like to personally thank, publicly thank, Congressman Martin Romualdez for taking me in Lacas CMD and accepting the challenge to be my campaign, one of the, my two campaign managers during the last election. It was not without irritations and challenges, but you did very well.
In her statement Wednesday, Duterte would go on to score the behavior of what she called sycophants in recent political developments, as she also maintained her support for the president. On Thursday, Santa Rosa Representative Dan Fernandez opted for a softer approach to Duterte, appealing to her for unity, while Dalipe and Pimentel would reiterate calls to end the bickering while extolling Romualdez with no reference to Duterte. For his part, Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Dong Gonzalez stuck to praising Romualdez. Through it all, Romualdez has kept quiet. In his own press release on Thursday, Romualdez's office would only talk about how he welcomed the latest World Bank forecast, indicating the Philippine economy is poised to expand faster than expected this year, before talking about how he intends to remain focused on his work and then discussing his achievements as Speaker. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. denies he is pushing away China while he's boosting ties with other countries. Marcos spoke at an event hosted by a group that aims to promote better Philippine-China relations. The president insists these relations remain fundamentally unchanged despite recent maritime tensions between the two countries. He notes Beijing has agreed to establish communication lines with Manila to tackle their disputes in the West Philippine Sea.
We continue to foster the friendship, the relationship, the partnership that we have been developing with China since 1974 and 1975 when it became official. So that's how I describe it. It is a continuing search to find solutions to the challenges that we face jointly with China.
Marcos Jr.'s remarks followed his earlier statement declaring his administration's neutral foreign policy. Debris suspected to be part of a Chinese rocket recovered in waters near the Philippine province of Bataan. The Philippine Coast Guard says the wreckage resembles the top section of China's Tanju rocket. The debris is now in the safekeeping of the Coast Guard in Limay, Bataan. China launched its Long March 7 rocket on May 10th in Hainan Province. The Philippine Space Agency had warned rocket debris might fall into the waters near Zambales Province. Southeast Asian nations set for their first ever joint military drills in the South China Sea. The exercise, which will take place in the North Natuna Sea in September, comes amid Beijing's increased aggression in the disputed waters. ASEAN bloc observer Timor-Leste will also be participating. Indonesia says the drills will focus on maritime security and rescue and will not involve combat operations. The ASEAN nations have held naval drills with the U.S. before, but never as a bloc on its own. Beijing asserts ownership of most of the South China Sea, despite competing claims from other Southeast Asian nations, including the Philippines.